Accucare Physical Therapy and Sports Medicine in Brick, New Jersey offers a state-of-the-art facility with all the best and current treatments. With athletic trainers, massage therapists, and doctors of physical therapy, Accucare has everything you need to stay healthy and perform at the highest level. Cupping, stretching, laser therapy, compression boots, and a full body cryo chamber are just some of what you can expect at Accucare. Check out their website and social media links in my bio. No prescription is needed to see them. So call them today and start feeling and performing at your best. Again, thank you to Accucare for sponsoring the Shore Football Report. Everybody, this is Rob Davis from the Shore Football Report. We got so much to do. You are watching Shore Football Report's all-star package teams, and we're going to have so many shows, and we'll talk a lot about it. But first, I want to do something. I want to thank Accucare for being our title sponsor for the whole 2022 high school football season. Couldn't have did anything without you. And, of course, number one, the owner and founder, Pam Anthony, and her tremendous staff. They've been great. They've been great to us all year. I love the fact that what they do with their athletes on the side, where they work with the athletes all year round with rehabilitation and recovery. And I love their top-notch facilities, which you guys need to go watch and go utilize. And also the way they communicate with their athletes. There is definitely a connection, a bond. They're winners. And I knew that. So I wanted to expand the Shore Football Report in the second year in existence that we had. So I did two major additions to the Shore Football Report. One was Accucare. Accucare became our title sponsor, and the rest is history. They've been tremendous with us. The one thing I really like is that what they do is they donate, okay, the overall players of the week get a free recovery session, and the athletes will be going in there if they won the winners of each week overall in the Shore Conference, and they donated that. And watching them work in there and bonding with that great staff was tremendous. I loved watching that, and I'm proud that they're part of our team. The other hire that we got was Scott Stump. Scott Stump came onto our the Shore Football Report, and he was an incredible addition to our staff. And I am blessed to have both of them, Scotty Stump and Accucare. I couldn't have did it without you guys. I owe you a lot. I really owe you a lot. And you know, I'm very, very loyal to you guys, and I appreciate everything that you have done. Pam Anthony and the Accucare staff, thank you. Thank you very much. All athletes need to go to Accucare and work out there, rehabilitate, recovery. All athletes, guys, girls, winter sport, spring sport, of course, high school football, get to Accucare and Brick. You know our commercials that we post out, throughout the weeks and all that stuff. And you're going to keep hearing me throw out Accucare and this and that. And we're going to have a big, big commercial that we're going to do, us and Accucare, for you guys. And they're there. They're centrally located in between Ocean, Monmouth County, and Brick, and just a great spot, and it's a great place to just get better as an athlete. I love the fact that you're not only taking care of your body and the mind, too. It's a focus. It is an attitude, and they're winners, and I just am so proud to be around them. Now, let's talk about the Shore Football Report's All-Star Packages. Guys, I was a head coach and assistant coach for 27 years. So I've been on the committees. For 10 years, I was a rep. The last 10 years of my coaching at Barney. I was a rep where I was involved in all the different all-star team committees. And it bothered me. It bothered me that there was always that cutoff. There always was a cutoff. In other words, you might do only first team. You might stop at second team. You don't do honorable mentions. You pack up and you leave. Well, there was a lot of names that I used to see on the board or on the table that were left off that, you know, wondering, you know, maybe those players and their parents didn't know that they were being talked about, but just missed those all-star teams. So when I started the Shore Football Report, I loved to play Santa Claus. I loved to play Santa Claus. So what I did was I expanded the teams. I added more players on each team, and I expanded the teams. So let me talk about what we're going to do. We're going to present 30 all-star shows starting December 13th. And let's talk about it. All right? December 13th is going to be all division teams. And each division gets their separate show. 7 different shows. We're going to have first and second teams for all division. And then we're also going to have award winners for each division. I pick an MVP, an offensive player of the year, defensive player of the year, special teams player of the year, O-line, D-line player of the year, sophomore or freshman player of the year, and unsung hero is a player who just doesn't get all the accolades, the ink, and all that type of stuff by the media like yours truly or others out there. But they're definitely going to be recognized. And we pick one for each division. We have fun with that. All right. So December 13th, we're going to do an all division team. 7 different ones. I don't like to put one big one, 7 different ones. You can just watch your division or you can watch all of them separately, though, with that. 2 days later, December 15th, I do an all county. Ocean and Monmouth County. And with that, we'll have 4 teams. We'll have 4 teams. So you're talking about 152 players for each county getting recognized. 152 for all county. 2 days later, we pick an all-shore team, 5 teams. And we are going to have 190 players on that. So those are all separate shows. And then we do an all-region, and that's new. The all-region is something I thought of that these local newspapers cover certain high schools in areas. So I figured, let's make a region out of it. I picked 10 regions, and I put teams in regions, and you're going to see an all-star team in those regions. Example, the Tom Driver School District, all 3 Tom Drivers in Donovan, the Freehold School District. You're going to have, the south of the border, Central, Southern, Lacey, Pinelands, and Barnegat. So I clump it in, and what it does, it just puts different groups of guys in, and I make an all-star team out of those. Where your local newspapers are covering it, I'm making all-star teams of that. It's fun. I know it is. Trust me. I enjoy doing it. You're going to love that. But there's going to be one team for each one of those regions. So there'll be 10 regions. There'll be one team for that. I got a all groups. So if you're group 1, group 2, 3, 4, 5, or non-public, you're going to be non-public, all non-public in the Shore Conference, all group 5, all group 4, all group 3, 2, or 1, and I'll have fun with that. So you're going to be grouped in with different groups of players, and you'll be able to make an all-star team with that. And then the last one, which everybody loves, is how are you in terms of each grade level? So I'm going to have an all-senior team, an all-junior team, an all-sophomore team, and you got it, an all-freshman team will be on the Shore Football Report. A lot of names are going to be there. Over 266 players will be mentioned in all those teams. Going to have a lot of fun. And I like to call it the holiday season, postseason all-star teams. All right? I love to play Santa Claus. So here I am. All right? Santa Claus is coming real soon, and so is my all-star teams. Make sure you go on the shorefootballreport.com and look at all the all-star teams, and don't wait for Coach Dave to send you the links. Go there, do yourself a favor, go to that website and check out when those all-star teams come out. And remember, it's not about you and I, it's about the kids. And the kids are the important ones. They supplied us with so much entertainment, wins, losses, whatever it is. High school football is the greatest sport out there. And you did a great job. All the coaches, all the players, all the fans, I'm wishing you Merry Christmas and enjoy everything. And the Shore Football Report definitely appreciates all of you guys. All right? Make sure you go to Accucare too. That would be a great Christmas gift. See you later. Hey, it's Rob Davis, the Shore Football Report. I will be presenting the Accucare 2022 All-Patriot Division postseason individual award winners. And then we will present the first and second team All-Division team for the Patriot Division. Let's get started with our MVP. Our MVP for the Patriot Division goes to an athlete, a junior. He's the glue to the team. He does it right on the field and off the field. And every time I meet this kid, he is a pleasure to talk to. Just very positive about his program. And that goes to wide receiver, defensive back, junior, Asbury Park, Raleigh Stevens. 5'10", 160, but plays bigger than that. He does it all for Asbury Park. For Coach Lamar Davenport, helped him get a 6-3 record in his first season. They won the Patriot Division with tri-champs, and they advanced to the South Jersey Group 1 state semifinal round. Great season Asbury Park had. As a receiver, he had 25 catches for 510 yards and 7 touchdowns. Also carried the ball for 242 yards and another 6 touchdowns. On defense, he was the quarterback of the defensive backfield. He had one interception there, and teams threw away from him, because he was a playmaker all the time. Raleigh Stevens just was the glue to the football team, helped them win a championship, and did everything. A jack of all trades for Asbury Park, and that's why he is the Shore Football Report's Patriot MVP for the division. Offensive player of the year goes to running back junior from Keyport, Nazir Treadwell. Nazir led his team to a 6-3 record. They, too, were tri-Patriot champions, and he had them go to the Group 1 state playoff appearance where they were in the South Jersey bracket. Very good season for Coach Glesman with Nazir Treadwell at offense, and you have to account for him anytime he's on the football field, wherever he's at. As a running back, he ran for 941 yards and 11 touchdowns, and he also caught 4 passes for 78 yards and a touchdown. He's been a starter since his freshman year. He's only a junior. We got one more year to showcase him in the Shore Conference, and he'll be one of the most explosive football players coming into the next season in the Shore Conference. Our offensive player of the year goes to that junior sensation running back from Keyport, Nazir Treadwell. Defensive player of the year goes to D. Lyman, who's a junior, from Shore Regional, Jackson Whitaker, big Jackson Whitaker, 6'4", 230, a Division I recruited athlete. His presence on the field makes teams want to go the other way. So they were 6-4 this year for Coach Cosentino. Tri-Patriot champions, they also had a share of it, and they advanced to the South Jersey Group 1 state semifinals this season. Very good season for Shore Regional. At the defensive end, Jackson had 46 tackles, 9 hits behind the line of scrimmage, 4 sacks, 1 fumble recovery, and 1 forced fumble. On passing situations, he always had to have a double team with him because he was so good off the ball. And with his size, he definitely demanded double teams with his presence there. So Jackson Whitaker also had 16 catches for 277 yards and 2 touchdowns for Coach Constantino and the Blue Devils right there. So our defensive player of the year goes to big Jackson Whitaker, the outstanding junior defensive end for Shore Regional. Special teams player of the year goes to another Shore football player, senior kicker punter Michael Furlong. Now, Michael just wasn't a kicker. He was a tight end. He was a defensive end. He played all the time, and he was a full-fledged football player for Coach Cosentino. Led the team to a 6-4 record. They were tri-Patriot champions and advanced to the South Jersey Group 1 state semifinal there. As a kicker, Michael was known for booming the football. Great loft on his kicks and great distance. 32 points as a kicker, 3 field goals. 32 was his longest successful field goal, and 23 extra points. He had 2 kickoffs for touchbacks on special teams. On offense, he had 4 catches for 53 yards and 2 touchdowns. On defense, he had 28 tackles at defensive end, 7 hits behind the line of scrimmage, 3.5 sacks, 1 forced fumble, and a blocked punt. To add to his kicking, as a punter, he averaged 28.2 yards a kick. 6 kicks went inside the 20, making him our special teams player of the year, senior kicker punter from Shore, Michael Furlong. O-line, D-line, player of the year goes to a junior offensive guard, defensive end from Shore, Jake Papara. When you think of a Shore football player, a tough, hard-nosed kid, a black belt guy, you think of Jake Papara. He was the glue to the O-line and also a major contributor for the defensive line for Coach Kaz. They were 6-4 with Jake on both sides of the ball, and they were a tri-Patriot champions, advanced to the South Jersey Group 1 state semifinals, and just was a tough, tough football player in the trenches. The offense had 1,921 yards rushing overall, and they averaged 22.6 in Coach Kaz's ball control offense. Defensively, he had 16 tackles with 3 hits behind the line of scrimmage, 0.5 a sack, and 1 fumble recovery, which helped Coach Kaz get another successful football season at Shore Regional. Our offensive line, defensive lineman, player of the year is junior O-guard DN Shore's Jake Papara. Top sophomore freshman player of the year goes to a sophomore, a quarterback linebacker from Keyport, Roman Blanks. Remember that name, Roman Blanks, because his name is going to be out there for the next 2 years. What a season he had for Keyport and Coach Glesman. 6-3 record, tri-Patriot championship they had, and they were playoff appearance in the Central Jersey Group 1 state playoffs this year for a sophomore linebacker. Quarterback, very successful with that. What did Roman do on offense? At a quarterback, he had 473 yards passing and 4 touchdowns. He also ran the ball for 177 yards and 4 touchdowns. On defense, he's physical. As an outside linebacker, he had 42 tackles, 6 hits behind the line of scrimmage, 3 sacks, and 2 fumble recoveries. A great mix of finesse and power. That's his game. Roman Blanks is a no wonder why he was our sophomore player of the year in the Patriot. Congratulations, Roman Blanks, Keyport sophomore quarterback linebacker. The last award goes to unsung hero. I love giving out this award. It goes to a player that deserves recognition, that he deserves. He's a high-level football player that maybe didn't get the right ink or the amount of ink. And you look at this winner right here at his position. The unsung hero goes to junior center defensive end from Keyport, Ryan Burns. And it goes to him because he's a 2-year starter already as a junior and just anchors the offensive line for Nazir Treadwell, run the ball. So he's his center, and everything goes through Ryan Burns, and played exceptionally well also on the other side at defensive end. Led Coach Glesman's team to a 6-3 record. They won the Tri-Patriot Championship. They were tri-champs with Keyport and also Asbury, Keyport Shore, Asbury Park. And they qualified for the playoffs of Central Jersey Group 1, which is a credit to him and his players there. On offense, they had 1,641 yards rushing. On defense, he was active with 35 tackles, 8 hits behind the line of scrimmage, 3.5 sacks, and 1 fumble recovery. Ryan Burns did a great job on both sides of the ball. He's a guy that will not be unsung next year. He will be one of the top linemen in the Shore Conference, without a doubt, with his experience and his athletic ability. Proud to say our unsung hero for the Patriot Division is the junior center defensive end from Keyport, Ryan Burns. Now, let's finish up the All-Patriot division, and let's show you guys the first and second teams.